Hi guys, so today I'm here to discuss another section of paper 1, which is information communication technology. So the question that follows are from question 26 to 30 of 150 question series. Do subscribe to this channel for more informational videos, and I hope that you all are liking my videos. So to proceed, first question which follow is: microprocessors as switching devices are for which generation computers? So first generation computers use vacuum tubes. Second generation use transistors and diodes. Third generation computer used integrated circuits. And the fourth generation computer used the microprocessors. And fourth generation was from 1972 to 2010. Now it is fifth generation computers, which involves in artificial intelligence. So technology is booming, and this section is basically about technology, computers, and we all have read computers as a subject in our schools. So the questions that are being asked in this section is pretty easy and of base level. So the another question, which is question number 27, the ALU of your computer responds to the commands coming from. So first let me tell you what ALU is. ALU means arithmetic logical unit. So as the name suggests, what arithmetic logical unit means that this section, this part of the computer performs all the arithmetic operations which are being sent by us, commanded by us. So basically the question which asks is that ALU of a computer responds to the commands coming from. So primary memory is basically that part which holds the data, for processing. The second one is the control section. Now control section, let me tell you, CPU is there, which we all know. CPU is the brain of the computer. It is also known as the brain of the computer. CPU has two parts, which is one is control unit, the another is ALU unit. Now let me make an analogy to make you understand this concept. CU, which is the control unit, it is like an orchestra leader. It doesn't perform anything, but it commands the other systems of the computer to perform. So basically it is the command. It gives the command to all the other sections. So basically the question here is that ALU listens to which, responds to command coming from. So the answer here will be control section. Now the external memory, as we know, that it is the memory which has been externally attached to the computer. Examples are hard drives, magnetic tapes, tape drives. Now cache memory is basically to increase the performance of the computer. Now the next question is 28, which of the following is not an example of the primary memory? Now primary memory, we know that it is accessed directly by the CPU. So it stores the data and processes the data. So the examples of the primary memory would be RAM, ROM, cache memory, but magnetic tape is a kind of external memory here. So the answer here is option number 4. Then we have question 29. That which is the largest unit of storage among the following? So let me tell you that one bit is equals to the binary digit. One bit is equals to binary digit. So let me start with the smallest one. So 1024 kilobytes, this is equals to 1024 kilobytes. Gigabyte is 1024 megabytes. Terabyte is 1024 gigabytes. So after this, it follows 1024 terabytes, then further. So let me tell you, let me provide you with a little more information regarding this. After terabyte, it comes petabyte, then comes the exabyte, then comes the zettabyte, and then comes the yottabyte. So the answer here is the largest unit of storage among the following. So the answer would be option number 1, which is terabyte. Then the last question of this section is the file extension of Excel spreadsheet. As we know that doc is the Word document, XLS is the Excel document, Excel worksheet. TXD is the unformatted version of the Word document. PPT is all we know is the PowerPoint presentations. This is PowerPoint presentations. Now, so the answer here will be option number 2. So as you can see that the questions from this section is pretty easy. We all have read computers in our schools and it could be easily managed. So ये जो questions हैं सारे के सारे ये काफी easy हैं. आप इनको अच्छे से पढ़ सकते हैं. आप इनका base clear कर सकते हैं. Computers हम सब ने पढ़ी हुई हैं. So, आपको कोई और query हो, कोई concept आपको clear कराना हो, कोई mechanism हो, तो आप ज़रूर पूछिए. और आपको ये ध्यान रखना है कि जो main concept होता है इस चीज़ में वो होता है CPU की mechanism. तो आप CPU की mechanism भी ज़रूर से एक बारी देखिए कि कैसे एक computer work करता है from the starting, कैसे उसका कैच मेमोरी जो है वो रैम से रिट्रीव करता है डेटा फिर वो प्रोसेस करता है फर्दर. तो आपको ये छोटे छोटे कॉन्सेप्ट्स पता होने चाहिए टू एक्सेल इन दिस सेक्शन. सो 5 क्वेश्चंस आएंगे इस सेक्शन में से और ये काफ़ी इजी सेक्शन है. अब आप ज़रूर सब्सक्राइब कीजिए इस चैनल को जिससे कि आपको नोटिफिकेशंस मिले, आपको वीडियोस की नोटिफिकेशंस मिले, आपको इंफॉर्मेशनल कंटेंट मिले और आप अपना इस जेआरएफ का जो एग्ज़ाम होगा वो आप क्लियर कर पाए. डू जॉइन आवर टेलीग्राम ग्रुप एंड डू मैसेज ऑन आवर टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर योर क्वेरीज. वी विल डेफिनेटली असिस्ट यू. थैंक यू.